Now, the PRACE Council is the deliberative body. So it is, in fact, the body that is making the decisions within PRACE. And the council is composed of delegates from the various countries that are contributing to PRACE. And the council meets 3 to 4 times per year. It is, in fact, supported by a certain number of advisory boards. One of the advisory boards is the Strategy Working Group. It is a subset of the PRACE Council. And the Strategy Working Group does work on strategic issues that need some time to be discussed, deliberated among the members of the council. Then we have the Scientific Steering Committee that's advising on scientific affairs. And we do have also the Industrial Advisory Committee advising on industrial affairs. And there is the Board of Directors, headed by the Managing Director of PRACE, and the Board of Directors is the executive body that is executing, in fact, the decisions made within the Council. In the area of science, we all know that modeling and simulation is playing a very important role. There are many, issues that cannot, or problems cannot be solved by using experiments, mainly because some experiments are not possible, but also mainly because some experiments are very expensive or take too much time. And in that sense, it's very important to do modeling and simulation. So it has been accepted and adopted by the science community as the third pillar of science. In that sense, it's very important to provide scientists in Europe with enough computing capacity to tackle all those problems. And this is what PRACE does. PRACE offers all the scientists enough computing capacity, and we need to give them open access to those facilities, but we need to give them also diversity of architecture, because various communities require various architectures. And we organize peer review, because one of the principles of PRACE is allocation of computer time based on scientific excellence. So we do peer review. Some healthy competition is good among the scientists. So in that sense, this is what the PRACE is offering. And of course, it's very important to do the technology transfer from science to industry, so to support the economy and also develop intellectual property rights for Europe. Now, the access to the industry is based, in fact, also on scientific and technological excellence. It is done in the pre-competitive atmosphere. So this means that the companies have to disclose the results of the research that's being done, supported by PRACE, because it is public money. And we have two programs, one program for the small and medium enterprises and one for the big industry. And we support them also with the trainings and also preparation of their work on the supercomputers. I must say that I'm very pleased to see that Europe is really competing, is able to compete with the other parts of the world, if we talk about the United States, but also Japan, China, South Korea. So we do have a good position, also thanks to PRACE, thanks to the collaboration among the member states, so that they share resources and offer, let's say, enough computing power to the scientists in Europe. It is very important to be prepared for the future, and what we see now is that there is this exponential increase of data. This exponential increase is leading also to a merger between supercomputing and big data, and there is also this exponential increase in computing power. So we do have in Europe what we call exascale data initiative. So the exascale data initiative is mainly focused on providing scientists in Europe in the future with exascale capabilities to tackle all those problems.